Are you ready for a new node? Let's jump into Houdini 19 and check one out.
Vellum shape match. This node is awesome. It's the Vellum super rigid constraint. Before this, you'd have to dial up stiffness and substeps and hope for the best. With this constraint, you have something that works a lot smarter and faster, and it's in the Vellum toolkit, so now we can get some great interaction with the other Vellum nodes. Let's take a look at the constraints and what it can do. Let's start with a trusty old sphere for our test. We'll change it to polygon, we'll set the uniform scale to 0.5 and give it a frequency of 5. Let's also move it up on Y by 2 units. Next, let's add a Vellum constraint. In the constraint type, let's change it to the last one, shape match. We also need to initialize some mass and some thickness. I'll use calculate uniform for both. I'll also give the density a higher value of 2, making the objects heavier in the scene. Let's attach a Vellum solver, 4 substeps, and let's add a ground plane. Now we can hit play. Magical, and just like that, we have a nice solid shape. Thanks for watching. Obviously, this isn't the most complicated setup, so let's add a few more objects and see what happens. Let's add a torus, let's change the shape to 0.15. Let's also make the uniform scale 0.5. Then we'll drop a line, give it 20 points, sweep it set to round tube and 12 columns. We'll also add a grid as the end caps. I love making tubes and capsules this way. Let's add a match size to get it centered. Let's put all these objects into a merge, and then we'll use a connectivity node. We'll change the attribute type to variant. On the right, let's add an attribute randomize. We'll turn on visualize as points and set it to 25. Let's set the distribution to inside sphere. We'll also increase the global scale a little. I love using this to create a scattered bunch of points. Let's drop down 2 more attribute randomizers. The first set to P scale. Change it to a single dimension as it's a float. We'll use a min of 0.4 and a max of 1.5. Let's change the second attribute randomize to orient, and we're going to set it to 4 dimensions and inside sphere. This will give us some nice random rotation. Now we can move the whole setup shape by 4 units with a transform. Next, we'll use an attribute from pieces. We'll add variant as the piece attribute and set its mode to random. Let's use a relax to get rid of some of the intersections. We'll uncheck the normal attribute and give it 5 iterations. We'll use a copy to point with the piece attributes enabled. This will now copy random pieces per point. This is a super useful workflow for many setups. I'm going to use a point velocity to push my objects to the floor with a strong downward velocity. Let's set it to negative 25 for now. Let's plug that in. Lots of shapes and it's still looking great. But what happens when you don't have perfect stiffness and you want it? Let's emulate that by reducing the strength stiffness in the shape match constraint. Now, we hit play and we get this weird jelly looking thing. If you look at the help docs on the shape match, you'll notice that it mentions using an extract transform with transform pieces SOP to avoid deformations. So let's have a look at how that setup can work. First, we need another connectivity so that each object has a unique class attribute. Now, after our simulation, we'll use an extract transform with piece enabled, and we'll change this to class, as that is what we're setting in the connectivity SOP. This is also a point attribute, so let's change the attribute class. Then we'll use a transform pieces node to transform our original geometry with Vellum simulation. Let's change the attribute to class, and now we have a fully rigid object that we're rotating just like our simulation. Because shape match is a Vellum constraint, we can now really easily do some rigid simulations with soft body or cloth. Let's take a look at this setup and how we can have them interact. We'll take our original setup and duplicate it over. We'll remove the point velocity as we don't need that. Now we want to create the cloth. So let's create a grid and we want it just bigger than our object, so a value of 8 and 8 works. Let's reduce the rows and columns to 2x2. This helps with the remeshing. Let's remesh with a value of 0.06. We're going to create a point group. Uncheck the base group and check include by edges and unshared edges. This will select our border edges. We'll use this in the Vellum cloth constraint to pin our edges. Let's configure Vellum cloth and then let's pin our edges. Now, after playing with a few settings, the main parameters at play here are the Vellum stretch stiffness and the shape matches mass or density. These values will determine how much the object will sink into the cloth versus how much they'll bounce off the top of it. For now, we'll use a value of 5x10. We'll also increase the damping ratio so Vellum doesn't try to solve the constraints forever, giving us like a jelly effect. I'll also decrease my rest length scale to 0.2. This will create a really nice tight cloth to start off. Otherwise, my cloth will just fall down and this isn't what I wanted. In the bend stiffness, I used the value of 0.0001. I also decreased the rest angle scale to match that of the stretch constraints. Now to get them to work together, we can just merge the geometry and constraint streams and plug them into our Vellum solver. We'll add a little velocity damping. This just removes some energy that Vellum shape match introduces. You can obviously change the settings and you get different looks. Here are some different examples. Another really useful feature of the shape match constraint is plasticity. This is not meant to replace Bullet by any means, but when working within Vellum, if you need plasticity, this node handles it quite well. Let's take a look at some of the settings. I have a simple pig head, and on the right I have some animated tubes coming down as a collider. If I hit play, this is what we get. I'd say this is a win. Let's now turn on plasticity. We'll give it a rate of 100. So it hardens as the state changes. In my test, this is the main parameter to adjust. Hardening is also useful if you want some hardening effects over time, such as hardening plastic. Now we're getting some nice plasticity, but our geometry is getting totally ruined. This is because that shape match constraint is trying to maintain the rigid form. So what we can do is add a vellum cloth constraint to the stream. This will give the pig head additional constraints, which will help maintain its shape. Now we're getting too much bending of the polygons, so we'll increase the bend stiffness. Now we run into the problem that the cloth constraint is returning to its rest state, so we'll enable plasticity on the cloth's bend constraint and up the rate again. Now we get something a little bit more stable. As this is Vellum, you can obviously add in edge fractures and weld points, setting a breaking threshold, and you do the same steps as we did before and you get some really cool metal breaking effects. There are so many more amazing things you can do with this constraint. I'm really excited to see what you come up with. But now it's your turn. Open Houdini, dive inside. It's Houdini time.